Yes, welcome to electronics class. In the previous class, we are discussing about most important amplifier. That is nothing but your CE amplifier. And as I said already, compared to the common base, common collector, and also common emitter, will give more importance to the common emitter. And why you are giving more importance to the common emitter amplifier? Already said in the yesterday's class, once again you recall what you said in the last class. Especially we want, it may be any electron device, always we want more current, also we want more voltage. And once we are having more current and more voltage, no doubt we are having more power. Especially for your why we prefer the common emitter configuration, the important thing about in common emitter configuration is about you are having the more voltage gain, and also you are having more current gain, also you are having the more power gain. And also yesterday I said about you are having the another important thing, rather than your common collector and common base. Yes, in your common base you are having only more voltage gain, but not the current gain. In the same way for your common collector, you are having only the more current gain, but very less voltage gain. But we want both in the same time. We want more current gain, you want more power gain. That is coming only in your CE amplifier. That is coming only in your CE amplifier. And here, why will get the more current gain in your common emitter amplifier? Yes, it is also possible in your common collector. But as in your common emitter, how will you get the more current gain and how will you get the more voltage gain simultaneously? The one important thing for your beta, that is nothing but current amplification factor. That is the ratio of the IC divided by IB. It is the ratio of the IC divided by IB. As we know already, the IC is nothing but the collector current, or it is nothing but output to the input. It is nothing but the output to the input. It means it is nothing but the current gain. That is also called EI. And we know already for your transistors, especially if you use this equation, IE is equal to IB plus IC. It means as compared to the IB and IC, you are having the more IC, but IB very less. That's why here also you are having the more current collector current than the base current. Because as we know, in general working up your NPN transistor, always we want the very less base current. That's why you have done the base is so lightly doped. We want very less base current. And why you want less base current? Because we want the more current gain. And when you get more current gain, when you are having the, if you apply very very small input, but you get the very very more output. Only that is possible in your amplifiers. What is amplifier? In amplifier, you are applying very very weak signal in the input, but you will get the output very strong, or very more output signal, or a very strengthened output signal. That means you are applying very very, you are having very very small current in the input, but you get the very more current in the output. That's why the reason is that, as we know already, it may be the your CB, or it may be CE, or it may be the CC. You know, all these configurations of transistor, the current nothing but IE is very more, and it is nearly equal to IC. But as you know, IB is very less. It is very is less. And also, sir, as in your common collector, you are having very more current gain because of here you can measure in your common collector. That is nothing but the gamma. That is nothing but output IE to the IB. The difference in your common collector and common emitter. In your common collector, in your common emitter, you are measuring the output across IC, but in your common collector, you are measuring the output across IE. That's why in your common collector, you are having more current. But no doubt, as because I said your IE is nearly equal to IC, that's why in your common emitter amplifier, you are having the more current gain. In the same time, if you go for the voltage gain, why you get the more voltage gain in your common emitter amplifier? Because for voltage gain, that depends upon the resistances. That depends upon the resistance. As we know already, in your transistor, the input having the low resistance, and the output having the high resistance. And I said in the beginning, because of the why you are in very low resistance, because of your input is forward bias and output is reverse bias. And for example, I said already, if you are applying the 0.1 volt as an input, will get the output nearly about 5 volts. While you get the output is very more as compared to the input, you are having nearly about voltage gain very more. For example, the voltage gain AV nothing but V naught by VI. That is nothing but nearly about 5 by 0.1. That is nothing nearly about 50. You are having the more voltage gain. It means, as I said already, we are measuring the V. Here, V is equal to I into R for input section, and for your output section, I is, you take constant, it may be 1 milliampere, and here R is nothing but, you can consider the, yes, you can consider about 10 ohms. Or you can consider 100 ohms, it becomes 10, nothing but we get nearly about 10 into 0.1 volts. Or consider about, in general, I said already, because of the, you are having the low resistance in the input and you are having high resistance in the output, we will get the more voltage or progress the output section. That's where I am the more voltage gain in your common emitter amplifier. And this is because the reason is about the you are having the very low input resistance or low input impedance and you are having the very more output impedance. Because this property will get the more voltage gain in your common emitter amplifier. And finally, yesterday I said about so important about construction of and working of your common emitter amplifier. Once again, repeat this because it is so important for your exam point of view. And maybe yesterday we discussed in detail, but how much you are writing exam? What is the necessary steps you are writing exam? For that, you once again you draw the simple diagram. Yes, it is very simple, and you have to remember this. Why to remember this? It is so important question. As I said already, not only for your PO level, it may help if you go for your higher degrees. This is nothing but your RE and this is nothing but your CE, and here you are having the resistor, and that is nothing but you are having the common collector, you are having the collector, and you are having the base, and you are applying the voltage you are biasing, you are applying the voltage, you are biasing in your common emitter. Here you are applying the input signal. Yes, it may be the VI. The important thing is about the most important thing, the difference as compared to the your C1 and C2. Here we get the output across here. Here can measure the output, and that is nothing but your output will be out of phase. 0, V naught and time t. Look here, here you can apply the positive VCC here. Positive VCC, and this is your RC, this is your R1, and this is your R2, and make the emitter ground, and here can measure the output here. Yes, this is about the diagram of your emitter, base, and collector. I said already, first you want to draw the diagram, and what you have to write in your exam, in minimum points. First step, you have to write about where you are applying the input and where you are applying the output. Yes, you are going for the common emitter amplifier, it is something called CE amplifier. In the CE amplifier, yes, the emitter is common for input as well as output. It is common for input as well as output. And also, the important thing, we are applying the input from emitter, from base to emitter. We are applying the input signal from base to emitter, and we will measure the output across the collector and emitter. And by using the coupling cap C1, we can give the input signal, and while using your C2, we can measure the output across the C2. The C1 and C2, they are called coupling capacitors because they will couple, they will give the input to the, they will give the signal, or they will connect the one circuit to the other circuit, you can say. And the important thing about, they will only allow the AC, they will block the DC, and you are using R1, R2 and RC and RE, that makes your input as forward bias and output as reverse bias, and also you are using the voltage divided biasing, the R1, R2, that makes the voltage divided biasing, and RC and RE and R1, R2, and also that's VCC, that makes the input as forward bias and also output as reverse bias. And in this condition, only your transducts in the active region, and also we want Q points in the middle active region. That Q point depends upon your VCC, R1, R2, and RE, and also that RC. This is about the construction, and as I said already, this is about construction. While explaining about the working principle, whenever you're applying the E signal, if you are applying E signal, and E signal having the positive half cycle and negative half cycle, but you have to explain in the different way. First you consider positive half cycle, what is the effect, and next you consider the negative half cycle, what is the effect. For example, yesterday we discussed already, but in general, for positive half cycle, and for negative half cycle, here I just said you are applying the positive half cycle. Because of the positive half cycle, they will increase the input voltage, and if you are increasing input voltage, nothing but you are increasing the forward bias. Yesterday I said arrow upwards indicate increase, arrow downwards indicate decrease, and because of you are applying the positive half cycle, you are considering the positive half cycle, because that reason what happens, the forward bias increases. And as we know already, in your common emitter amplifier, which one is input? That is something but your IB. IB will be, yes, it will be increases. And if the IB increases, no doubt, the IC also increases, because input increases, the output also increases. And once the output increases, no doubts, the voltage across RC also increases. It means IC into RC increases. And in the same time, what happens? The VCE will be decreases. The reason behind this, if you apply the KVL to the output section, that becomes VCE equal to, write the equation in your exam, VCC minus IC into RC. Right? It means here IC and RC increases, this term increases, you will get the negative value here, that means the output will be decreases. And at the same time, you can go for the half cycle, total opposite of this, forward bias decreases. The forward bias decreases, and if the forward bias increases, what happens? The input current IB decreases. And if the input current decreases, IC, the output current also decreases. And finally, what happens? IC into RC also decreases. And finally, what happens? The output voltage VCE increases. Because once again, this equation here, the VCC is constant. And here, what happens? IC and RC will be decreases. We will get the positive value. It means the output will be increases. In overall, what you have to say about the importance of your common emitter amplifier? The input and output are in the out of phase. They are in the out of phase. It means the input and output are in the 180 degree out of phase. The input and output are in the 180 out of phase. This is the importance of your common emitter amplifiers. And actually, yesterday I said already, the if the input is positive going side, but output is having the negative going side, and if the input is negative going, then output will go in the positive going side. Or I can say, if the input is increases, output is decreases. If the input is decreases, output is increases. It is a reverse process. That is nothing but your importance of your common emitter amplifier. And maybe up to this you can write in your exam. It is enough. And another important thing yesterday I said about if you go for the knowledge purpose, I am not saying exam point of view. If you want more knowledge, then only one small thing. Yesterday I said, what is the importance of your phase shift? It only occurs in your common emitter, not in your common base and not in your common collector. What is the importance of your phase shift? Especially the important thing in phase shift, it is useful in your oscillators. It is useful in oscillators. In oscillator, we want the phase shift. Because you are studying in the detail about oscillators in our further chapters. In oscillator, we want the total 360 degree phase shift. We want the total 360 degree phase shift. Especially if you go for the oscillators, yesterday or in the beginning class I said, what is oscillator? Oscillator is an electronic device. It will give the A signals, it will produce the A signal. Or another way of oscillator, in oscillator you are not giving any input, still you will get the output. And also another way of oscillator, oscillator nothing but it will convert DC into AC voltage. It means in your oscillator we want the 360 degree phase shift. But as I said, you are using the in oscillator you are using the amplifier, especially you are using the amplifier, the CE amplifier. Why you are in CE amplifier? Because the CE amplifier will give the 180 degree phase shift. And we want another 180 degree phase shift, that is given by your that is nothing but your tank circuit or the feedback circuit. Another 180 is given by your tank circuit or another 180 is given by your maybe your CE configuration. Or if you go for if you are using your op amp, especially if you the op amp it is using in your inverting amplifier. Op amp is used in inverting amplifier, that also will give the 180 phase shift, and also your CE amplifier also will give 180 phase shift. Remaining 180 is given by your tank circuit, or it may be your if you are using the RC oscillators, especially phase shift oscillator, there you are using 3 R and C combination, they will give the 180, and total you are having the 360 phase shift. Another important thing, this is the phase shift helpful in your oscillators. And what is the meaning of phase shift? What is the meaning of phase shift? Means the in the for example input and output arising some relation. The phase shift nothing but the output may be delay, or the output, what is the meaning of phase shift? Nothing but phase in phase outlets, or you can say in phase, and out of phase. Especially in phase, nothing but their current or voltage are moving in the same direction. In phase, nothing but the current and voltage are moving in the same direction. If they are out of phase, nothing but they are moving in the opposite direction. They are moving in the opposite. The current and voltage, they are moving in the opposite direction. That is nothing but the out of phase. It means the phase, nothing but that will give the relation between the input and output. How much the fast or how much delay your output is depends upon input. How much fast or how much delay is taken place about the output corresponding input. That information given by your phase shift. The output is delayed or output is how much it is very fast against ahead to the input. That will, that information was given by your phase shift. This is about the importance of your phase shift. Another I said about yesterday, actually your in your common emitter amplifier, I said input is input voltage is increasing, but output voltage is decreasing. Why? That is something but your phase shift. That is something but the input and output are the 180 out of phase. If your input is increasing, but output is decreasing, actually what happens? How the output will decrease? Because you are increasing the input voltage. Actually, we want, if the input voltage increases, no doubt output voltage also increases, but only in your common base and common collector that happens. But as in your common emitter amplifier, especially I said, actually here what happens, you are having more current, you are having IC is very more. And if you are having IC very more, means what happens? You are having more current flowing in the collector base section. And always the collector base section, the collector base junction should be in the reverse bias. If this reverse bias is very less reverse bias, means if the your collector base junction is very less reverse bias, in that amount of one, they will indicates the output will be VCE will be decreases. Or why the output decreases? Because of the high current, what happens? They will reduce the reverse bias. They will reduce the common, they will reduce the collector base junction, less reverse bias. And because of less reverse bias, what happens? They will, because that reason, what happens? The output voltage VCE will be decreases or reduces. In the same time, if you are going for the, if you consider the input voltage decreases, if the input voltage decreases, then whatever the output voltage, as I said, if the input voltage is decreases, nothing but the output current also decreases. And if the output current decreases, then once again what happens? Actually one, the collector base junction should be in the reverse bias. Here it is more reverse bias. In other words, more reverse bias. If the collector base junction is more reverse bias, it is nothing but we are having the VCE is more. Because the reverse bias that depends upon the output voltage. Especially the reverse bias that depends upon the output voltage. Output voltage, nothing but your VCE. Because you already studied the, if you are having the more reverse voltage, the depression layer also very more. And if the current very less reverse voltage are very, the depression are very less. It means by applying the more voltage to the output, we may increase or decrease the depression layer. That is especially about the contribution. This is about the simple way of why if the input is increases, why not the output is not increase, it is decreases. This is about the simple way of common emitter amplifier. And today we'll go for the another most important about yesterday said about your having the what are the most important characteristics of your common emitter amplifier. No doubt you are having more current gain, more voltage gain, more power gain, and also I said you are having a very moderate input impedance and moderate output impedance, and also I said about most important property of input output they are in the out of phase, 180 out of phase. These are the importance of your characteristics of your common emitter amplifier. And now we'll go for what are the applications where you are using this amplifiers. Especially you are using the amplifiers for your audio frequency amplifiers. You are using the audio frequency amplifier, also you are using your radio frequency amplifier, also especially you are using in your signal generators. You are using in your signal generators and also you are using in communication. In your communication you are using about communication, also you are using about the CE amplifier. Especially you want for the audio frequency amplification, radio frequency amplification, in signal generators, and also about in communication you are using about the this common emitter amplifier. Especially I said about in oscillators and so many way where you want more current gain, more voltage gain, we are going for the common emitter amplifiers. Now we'll go for another most important about what is the, they ask the question about the frequency response of your common emitter amplifier. The frequency response of CE amplifier. Look here, what is the importance of frequency response and what is the effect of the frequency on the gain? Especially you would rather, what is something about the frequency response? Actually it is a graphical representation of the voltage gain corresponding to frequency. For different frequencies, what is the voltage gain? For different frequencies, what is the voltage gain? Especially as I said already, we are giving more importance to the bandwidth. What is bandwidth? The band of frequency, range of frequency, up to this we want gains to be constant. It means for different frequency we want the send signal, the maximum can send a signal for different frequencies, or you can say about amplifier can able to identify the quality of the amplifier. We always we want more bandwidth, nothing but we want more frequency, the gain should be constant, right? It means actually the what is frequency response? It is a graphical representation of the frequency versus output, frequency versus the voltage gain. Here you can consider about actually that you can draw the like that, you'll get the frequency response. And here I may get the AV, the maximum at here 0.707 times AV, and here it may be the 0, here it may be the AV in the voltage gain, here it may be the frequency. Especially here it is your FL, and this is your FH, and this is nothing but the the bandwidth, nothing but FH minus FL. The important thing is about for your what is nothing but frequency response. It is a graphical representation of for the different frequency what is the effect of the output voltage gain. For different frequencies, what is the effect of the output voltage? Or you can say the range of frequencies, how much range of frequency, band of frequency, your output will be constant. That is given the information about the frequency response. Actually, here the important thing about, as you see here, this is the for your lower frequency, this is nothing but some lower frequency, this is nothing but higher frequency. Especially for the lower frequency and for higher frequency, yes, what happens? The higher frequency, the gain will be reduces. And for your mid frequency, the gain will be constant. Especially what understand here, overall I am saying about frequency response, as in the mid band, the gain will be constant. For the lower frequency and for higher frequency, the gain will be reduces. It means the voltage gain will be reduces. Only for the mid band frequency, we are having the voltage gain will be constant. Right? And actually I said, we want the bandwidth more. It means if the bandwidth is very more, in that time we want more the voltage gain, because as I said, range of frequency, band of frequency we want, the voltage gain will be constant. The how much range of frequency or voltage gain is constant, that is given by your frequency response, and that is nothing but your bandwidth. Especially you want more bandwidth, especially you want wide bandwidth, or you can say you want infinite bandwidth, but that is not possible. In theoretically you can say about infinite bandwidth, but practically not possible. It may be narrow band or maybe wide band. It means the bandwidth that depends upon the frequency, because bandwidth nothing but the higher cutoff frequency minus lower cutoff frequency. As I said about already, bandwidth nothing but range of frequency or band of frequency up to which the gain will be constant, or I said about the gain will be 0.7 or something maximum gain. The range of frequency, the band of frequency up to which the gain will be equal to or more than the 0.7 or 70.7% of the maximum gain. That also given by your bandwidth. And now we'll go for the, what is the effect? Why the gain will be reduces for lower frequency, and why the gain will be reduces for higher frequency? Why only gain will be constant for the mid frequency and mid band frequency? We'll go for that. And first you consider about the low frequency. What is the effect of the low frequency? Why in low frequency the gain will be reduces? Look here, in overall, as I said already, in your in any amplifier, you are using active components, also you are thinking about the passive components. Especially if you are going for the frequency response, you are giving importance to the capacitors. Working of capacitors, because as I said, in your amplifiers we want more voltage gain, and also we want the, in amplifiers we want the constant voltage or constant current. That especially in your here, according to frequency response, you want the constant here voltage gain. This constant voltage gain, that depends upon your capacitors. That depends on working of your capacitors. And as I said already, you are using for resistor in your amplifier to limit the current, or it may help to your divide the voltage or to control the current, or especially you are using in your RE, in your C amplifier, that makes the stability of the Q point. These are the about importance of resistance. But what are the importance of capacitor? Capacitor, as you know already, especially for lower frequency, the gain will be reduces. Why the gain will reduces at lower frequency? As we know already, the FC nothing but the XC, the capacitive reactance, XC is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi FC. You know this is a very important relation. The XC nothing but the capacitive reactance. The capacitive reactance nothing but the the opposition offered by the capacitor to the flow of AC current. What is nothing but XC? The capacitive reactance. The capacitive reactance nothing but the opposition offered by the capacitor to the flow of AC current. That is nothing but the XC. Especially the capacitive reactance, that is inversely proportional to the frequency. That is inversely proportional to the frequency. And here actually what happens? Because of the lower frequency, what happens? Because of lower frequency, what happens? XC will be very more. Because of lower frequency, XC will be very more. You can write XCR, you can write about simple, you can write about resistance. XC nothing but reactance, and or you can write about resistance. For your lower frequency, what happens? You are having the very more reactance. It means you are having very more resistance. And as we know already, if you are having the more resistance, or if you are having the more opposition, it means it is not allowing the signal to the your transistors. Right? What is the importance of capacitor? Because you are using the coupling capacitor, or you are using for bypass capacitor, especially for lower frequency, effect of the coupling capacitor and also effect of the bypass capacitor. Bypass capacitor. Especially the coupling capacitor, they will couple the input and also they will couple the output. As you know already, C1 nothing but through the C1 you can give the input, and through the C2 you can get the output. When you are, if the C1 is very more C1, because the reactance of the coupling capacitor very more, it is not allowing the input signal towards the emitter base section. Because of the very high value of your C1, that is not allowing the input signal moving towards the emitter base section. Also, in C2 is having very more, because of C2 also very more, it is, you are not getting more output voltage. You are not getting the more output voltage. If it is not allowing the more input voltage, if it is not allowing the more output voltage, nothing but the gain will be reduces. That's why the gain will be here, the gain will be reduces. Because it is not allowing the more input voltage, because of input voltage very less, the output voltage also very less. That's what happens, gain will be reduces. Or you can say about, actually you are giving the input signal through the signal generator, or you are using the source, signal having some resistance, signal generator having some resistance. That source resistance and this capacitive reactance, they will be in series. Means they will allow oppose further, they will more oppose the input signal. Because of the capacitive reactance and signal having some resistance, they will be in the series. Because at opposite, we are having the more opposition for the input signal. It means the C1 is not allowing the more input signal towards the emitter base section. And because we are having very less input entering to the transistor, that's why having very less output across the output, or C2 also it is not allowing more output across the load. That's why the gain will be reduces, because the importance about the capacitive reactance vary more for the low frequency. Once I repeat, for your low frequency you are having the more capacitive. In general, you are having the for low frequency gain will reduces because of the you are having the more capacitive reactance. This capacitive reactance having very more, we are having more opposition. It having, you can say right up way, we are having very more resistance. If you are having more resistance, that is not allowing the more current flow through that resistor, or it is not allowing more voltage entering to the emitter base action. That's why what happens, the gain will be reduces. This is about the importance of your low frequency, why the gain will reduces. The important thing about the effective reactance of capacitor varimode. This effective reactance opposes the input signal. The input signal is not moving very more towards the emitter direction. They will drop across the capacitor more. They will drop across capacitor very more. That's why having very less input, there is nothing but having less output. That's why you are having the gain will reduce. This is the board for the low frequency. Now we'll go for what is the effect of the high frequency. What is the effect of the high frequency? Yes, the important thing is about is so important conclusion. High frequency. What is the effect of the high frequency? Yes, we know the important thing, the XC for high frequency 1 divided by 2 pi FC. Here what happens? XC will be low. Especially for high frequency, we are considering about the another two capacitors. One is called your transistor capacitance, transistor capacitance tons, and also considering about the wiring capacitance. For high frequency, we are considering about the transistor capacitance and also considering about the wiring capacitance. Especially, we know about transistor capacitance as in you have studied in your first year. Especially for your diodes in reverse bias, your p-type semiconductor and n-type acts as a two plates, and in between the your depression that acts as insulator. In the same way, for your transistor also, you are having the two depression layer. And one is about, as we know about, one is about emitter base section, another about the collector base section. Here also a capacitor, here also a capacitor. These two capacitors and also that, what is called wiring capacitor? As we know, the capacitor is nothing but two conducting plates separated by electric medium. If considered any wire, in the wire you are having the some plastic coated, and also you are in the plastic, in the middle you are having the conducting material, and above that conducting you are having the plastic material also, that is also you are having the ground, the wiring capacitor nothing but that conducts that contains the two plates and also that rubber that acts as insulator, and its ground. And that conductor that acts that wire, what is inside that conductor? Copper wire is there, that is also one type of conduct, one type of plate. Another consider ground, that also one type of conductor. In between you are having the that plastic that acts as insulator. That is about wiring capacitors. These capacitors having the very low resistance. These capacitors having very low resistance because of the this transistor capacitance and wiring capacitance will be very low, and these transistor capacitance and wiring capacitance are very low. This low resistance is in parallel with the output resistance. This transistor capacitance and wiring capacitance some reactance. Because of high frequency, we are in very very low reactance. This very very low reactance in parallel with the output resistance. It means actually what happens, because always the current will move, we are having the very low resistance. Because of the transistor capacitance and wiring capacitance having very low reactance, and also this is in parallel with the your load resistance. It means what happens, all the current will drop across the capacitor, and very less current will move towards the load resistor. That's why what happens, if you are in the more current moving towards the or flowing across the capacitor, very less current will move towards the load resistance. It's nothing but you are having the very very less output voltage. That's why what happens, the voltage gain reduces. It means very simple, transistor capacitance and wiring capacitance having the very low reactance, very low resistance. This low resistance connecting it is in parallel with output resistance, and because of the property of current, current always flow where having the very less resistance, and because of the your capacitor having very low reactance, all the current will move towards the capacitor, and very less current or voltage, or you can say about very less, all the current and voltage move towards the capacitor, very less voltage and current move towards the your output, that is the load resistance, that's why the gain will be reduces. This is one important point about the why only in your for high frequency gain will be reduces. Another important thing point is about because once again for high frequency your capacitor having the very low resistance. Now you can write it about XC is nearly about zero, and the whenever the having the very less reactance, are having nearly about zero reactance. There is nothing but it acts in short circuit. It acts in short circuit. For high frequency, because of you are having very very less reactance, what happens? That your circuit acts in short circuit. And as we know, because of short circuit, what happens? They may affect. That is also called a loading effect. We are having the more loading effect, and because that reason also we can gain reduces. Why the gain reduces? Because of a loading effect. Why the loading effect? Because of the for high frequency or capacitor acts as a short circuit. In short circuit, very very more current that may damage your remaining components or devices. That's why we are having the loading effect. Because loading effect also can gain reduces for your high frequency. I said two reasons. One reason very simple, because of your transistor capacitance or it may be wiring capacitance will be very very less, and this very small reactance or resistance of your capacitance, your transistor capacitance or wiring capacity, they will be parallel with your output resistance, and all the current or voltage drop across your capacitor, very very less voltage and current drop across your output, at least your load resistance, that is why the gain will be reduces for high frequency. It is one reason. Another important reason is about for high frequency, what happens? The capacitor reactance is very very small. Because that reason, what happens? Your circuit, total circuit acts as a short circuit, and if it acts as a short circuit, means the it may loading effect. We are having a more loading effect because of the more loading effect. That's why what happens? The gain will reduces. This is about the why only the low frequency gain will reduces or gain will decreases, and also high frequency gain will reduces. And finally, go for the in the mid band. We are interested in the mid band because always we want gain should be constant. We want the gain should be constant only for in mid band, where having the gain will be constant. And why the gain will be constant for mid frequency? For mid frequency, you are having the gain will be constant. Why the gain will be constant for mid frequency? Once again, I said about because of the high frequency. Because of high frequency, what happens? Your XC is very more. Your XC is very more. If you are having XC is very more. Sorry, XC is very less. Sorry, XC is very less. Then what happens? Because of you are having very less opposition, it means you are having the more gain. Gain will be more. In the same time, I just said, if you are having very small opposition for high frequency, the gain will be more. In the same time, as the XC is very less because high frequency, actually what happens? It also acts as short circuit, and because of short circuit, they may affect the loading effect. Because of the XC is, because you are decreasing the capacitor reactance, because of the capacitor reactance decreases, that may act as a short circuit, and because short circuit, what happens? You are having the more loading effect. You are having the more loading effect, and actually at a certain condition in some particular time, what happens? These both the process will cancel each other, that makes the gain constant. At a particular frequency, what happens? it have some particular frequency because of the your XC is very less, we're having the more gain. And at some particular frequency, what happens in the mid band, we're having the XC is very very less. In that time, your attack short circuit, and because of more loading effect, what happens? The gain will be reduces, and at the same time, the both will be cancel each other. That makes the your gain constant. And another way of very simple. In low frequency, for low frequency, your circuit acts as open circuit. For low frequency, it acts as open circuit, and for high frequency, it acts as short circuit. But in the mid band, the open circuit and short will cancel each other. That makes the gain constant. It is a very simple reason about gain constant. Why the gain constant in mid frequency? For low frequency, your circuit acts open circuit. For high frequency, your circuit acts short circuit. And at the mid band, both will cancel. That makes the gain constant. This is about the why the gain constant for the mid frequency. And important thing is about in mid frequency, because of the more frequency, what happens? The effect, the capacitor reactance is very less. And if the capacitor reactance is very less, we are having the more gain. And it is one thing. Another, in the same time, another thing also happens. Because of the very less capacitor reactance, what happens? You are having the more loading effect. And because the both the process acts at the same time, they will each will cancel each other and will get the constant gain across the mid band frequency. This is about the importance of your why only the in the lower frequency gain reduces, and why the gain reduces in the high frequency, and only in the mid band or mid frequency where I am the gain will be constant. Right? One thing important in the overall, your why the gain will decrease or increase or it becomes constant, that depends upon the property of a capacitor. Right? And also the capacitor is depends upon the frequency, and because all these reasons we can say about the bandwidth. We are studying about bandwidth, and for example in C amplifier or any amplifier, we want more bandwidth. The bandwidth nothing but the range of frequencies or band of frequency, how much frequency range your output voltage is constant. And I'll say about that also indicates the effectiveness of the amplifier. That will say about the effectiveness of the amplifier. This is about the importance of frequency response of your C amplifier. Don't confuse. They may ask for 3 to 3 mark question for your exam point of view. First you draw the neat diagram and you explain about the why the for low frequency gain reduces, and why the for high frequency gain reduces, and why only in the mid frequency gain will be constant. Very simple. In low frequency, because of your having the more capacitor reactance, that's why gain reduces. And for your high frequency, you are having very very less reactance. That less reactance will in parallel with the low resistance. It means all the current or voltage drop across the capacitor, and that's why very low voltage and current will drop across the load. That's why gain will be reduces. Or you can say about because of the very less capacitor reactance, that short circuit that may affect the more loading effect. That's why you can also reduces here. But in the mid band, for low frequency it acts as open circuit, and for high frequency as short circuit. In the mid band, both will cancel. That makes the gain constant. And also, as I said, because of the high frequency, what happens? The gain will increases. And also because of high frequency, what happens? Your reactance, very very less reactance, they may affect the loading effect. And in this some time, both will cancel. That makes the gain constant. This is about the importance of your frequency response. And in the next class, we go for the importance of what is the effect of the DC analysis and AC analysis of your C amplifier. Thank you. One more, one more, one more.